bitch around here. Ice on my neck and it's froze. Santa's reindeer. You got bad. It's the same here. Bad company. Lil' bro, you can't hang here. Getting money, so keep on coming. So you know the jumping. They looking at me, he owe me some money.
I need that.
Hit him with the not the crumpin'.
Why
playing games? They don't want no problems with me. My got good. I know I brought them. Might not hit a bad. Someone send them for opposition.
They move wrong.
So I
dark shades, too much. Got the belly seat up. Acting brand new like I don't see it when I do. Who them folks? Who want too close? Give me room, phony folks. Play it close, do the most, don't they? Bad company, that's bad for your company. Bad company, that's bad for your company. Bad cow disease, now you in a ton of beef. Tucked underneath my new blue dungarees. Flintstone, bust down, color Maricami. Fruity pepper, bezel, Wilma, Betty, Fred, and Barney. Bad. I'm out of town, I think she model Abercrombie. Wrist game, Lucky Charmy, told my jeweler, leprechaun. I'ma come clean, I got heat. Paranoia got me rolling in my sleeves, okay. Waiting cause I'm up and up the freeze. Whole team got these on their tees all day. I got so much beef, I could barely sleep. Paranoia got me losing on my Z's all day. Good Lord, mama praying on the knees all day. If you still frontin' when I up there, I'ma squeeze.
I'm above average.
Brandon Gordon, Charles Davis, happy to be with you. And Charles, we've got two teams who know each other extremely well. These division games, they tend to be battles.
People scout like crazy in this league, but no one scouts more than within the division. Because if you win your division, you're automatically in the playoffs. That puts extra emphasis on these games, and they can't wait to get at each other.
Now the kicker, Brandon McManus, about ready to get us started. And we are underway from AT&T Stadium. That's fielded in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game. So what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on 2nd and 12. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And he checks this one down to Williams. And down he'll go at the 25. It's a gain of 6 on the play. And it'll be 3rd down.
I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game. And you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
McNabb to throw. This is Johnson. He's got it. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. First connection there of the afternoon for those two, and it's good for a first down.
Come on, let's go! Grand 38! Grand 38! Ohio!
On first and 10, McNabb. He's going to fire one. Deep left shot. That's caught at the 25. That goes for a gain of 31.
And Big Kelly Winslow played tight end in an era when the ball wasn't thrown around nearly as much as it is today. But he was fortunate to play for the Chargers, who did pitch it around pretty well, Brandon.
Well, yeah, you think about it, 7,000 receiving yards just south of that in just 109 games. That's how you become a three-time first-team All-Pro.
On first down, it's McNabb. He gets it left side to Johnson. And they'll get this down to the 10. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
Yeah, the opening script, however, they drew it up for this first drive, going to plan so far.
And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now. Here's second and goal, operating from the 8-yard line.
Come on, let's go! White 90! White 90!
Now it's McNabb. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
Once you get into the red zone and the safeties have less ground to cover, you'd better be quick with your delivery. Not much space to get a ball in there.
Yeah, when that field shrinks with those safeties, it's almost like there's a couple extra defenders out there, right?
It certainly is. They end up taking up extra space just because there's not enough space for receivers to run through.
To throw, McNabb. Keeps himself upright. But in the end, the pressure too great, and he goes down. Kenny Clark in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that'll lead to a fourth down. And McManus able to put it through, and the opening drive of the game yields 3.
So an opening drive field goal maybe doesn't whip this crowd into a frenzy, but I think that they will take the early lead.
There's no doubt about it. They will always take the early lead, and maybe that celebration comes later if they play well and they can break things open. But right now, this is all about letting the offense just get settled in.
And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on 2nd down.
Now they'll run the option to the short side left. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Now a play fake here on 1st down. And down he goes. They bring down Wentz on the sack. Reggie White in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. Now
following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Now Wentz. Buying time to his left. Now he's going to let it go deep left side. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Wentz. Flushed out right. He's going to run, but he's got a long way to go. 5 yards that time out of the scramble. But now they're looking at a fourth down situation.
And they had an extra defensive back on the field on that play, and the coverage was excellent. He tried to pull it down and run for it, but they rallied to him and kept him short of a first down.
Chased out left. Now he's going to let it go deep back. And that's caught inside the 35. And he's taken down all the way inside the LA 10. Wow, first and goal, and defensively all they can do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well. Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. They'll try and run. This is Williams. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. It's a good pickup of 7 yards, and now they're looking at second and goal. They'll run it with Williams. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And that'll make it third and goal. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Arlington right after this timeout. Wentz now on third and goal. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
Zone in zone. Airing one out for Boyd. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 45.
Sit down. on, we don't talk to the law. Yeah, they think I'm tripping, they listen. They know our every move, yeah, they want us all in prison. That's why I can't sleep at night until they get in. I'm on another mission, I'm just young and I'm living.
Yeah, I done seen the best of them jammed up. 25 to life and they can't stop. Never met a man that they can't talk. We're talking on the phone, they can hear us.
7 in the morning and they in my home. My bank account's froze, what is going on? Why it all start going wrong? From talking on the phone.
My phone still echo, the feds won't let go. Money never sleeps when you're the Black Gordon Gecko. Line looking like they waiting on the retro. Sixes, I feel special. Resale and I never pay retail. My shoebox money afforded.
Alongside my partner Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, happy to be with you. And CD, as we get this thing going, give the folks at home something to keep their eye on.
The running game for both teams, because I think this is going to be an old-fashioned, old-school type of a game. Physical, who wins up front, who runs the ball the best and controls the clock, they will come out the victor.
Now the kicker, Brandon McManus, about ready to get us started. And off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told, as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Down throw, McNabb. And it completes it to Boyd. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
First carry for the Hall of Famer, LaDainian Tomlinson. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
And that was the first carry of the game for LaDainian Tomlinson. His first touch, our first look at him in this contest.
That's so good. I remember at the time of his retirement, he was 5th all-time in career rushing yards, just under 14,000.
Yeah, how about that? 2nd in career rushing touchdowns with 145 as well.
Now McNabb drops this off to Tomlinson, complete. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 5 yards on the pickup, and it'll be 2nd down.
And this is why it was so tough for defenses to key in on LT. Showing off his catching ability there, he hits you every which way. 7th in all-purpose yards with nearly 5,000 yards receiving in his career.
Second down, it's Tomlinson. So he got 3 of 1 tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Tackle there by Leighton Vander Esch.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now, because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Two there, but on 3rd and 1, that's all they needed to keep the drive going.
Flex round! Flex round! Come on, let's go!
On the handoff, Tomlinson. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there.
Mika Fitzpatrick made the play defensively, the first round pick out of Alabama. They go play action. It's McNabb. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by linebacker C.J. Mosley. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. So good field position for the Packers as they come up first and 10.
There we go, here we go.
And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Ah, yes, Reggie White. I remember when they first started calling him the Minister of Defense. It was back at the University of Tennessee, snuffing out plays like that. Did you see that tackle for a loss? Mm-hmm. I remember him turning around the LSU game in 1983 with a similar play. Reggie White, one of the all-time greats.
13-time Pro Bowler, Reggie White. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Now Wentz throwing on second down, eluding the pressure right. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. It'll be a gain of 9. And make it third down. From the gun, it's Wentz. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. At 5 yards on the play there, as the drive will continue.
Hang in there now. Hang in there now. Lefty, lefty.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. Second quarter about to get underway with the Packers in possession of the football. And they've got it here with a first down. Wentz to throw. Escaping the pressure right. Looking long for his tight end. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. Touchdown, Packers. Jordan Reed, 44 yards. And the Packers are able to cash in for 6. And he puts it through. Now McManus on to kick this one off. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
Let's go!
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before that he always told his runners, Run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
Gun, McNabb. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he picks up about six as he gets this down to the 41.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of two, now third down. Gun on third down, wins. And he's going to go down. Back near midfield at the 49. Reggie White coming in to drop him for a loss of eight, and it'll be fourth down. They do go for it. It's Wentz. Steps away to his left. Now he'll let it go deep right side. That's going to be caught. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Carson Wentz with two first-half touchdown passes. And the Packers add six to their lead. And he knocks it through. Now McManus on to kick this one off. That's fielded in the end zone. Oh, good move. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to Baltimore after this. Shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Throw right side, caught by Winslow. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down.
When you struggle on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
And he'll get this up to about the 40. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
Here we go. Grand 38. Grand 38. Flex round. Flex round.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. And defensive back Jamal Adams in on the stop. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
Let's go! White, 90! White, 90! Flex round! Flex round!
From the gun, here's McNabb. And he's got a man. It's Kellen Winslow. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
Come on, let's go! White, 90! White, 90! Cut!
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense.
as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Throw on second, McNabb. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. A very solid gain of 27. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Checks this one down to LT out of the backfield. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. And McManus able to put it through. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Flush to his right. Open right side. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. And a nice gain of 21 yards. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. They go play action here on first down. Forced out to his left. Now he'll throw deep left side. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
To throw, it's Wentz. Now he's going to go deep down the left. That's caught inside the 20. And inside the 15 before they drop him. And give him a gain of 37.
In our pregame meeting, all they talked about was keeping him hemmed in and wanting him to make his throws from the pocket because they knew he was pretty dangerous if he got outside, and he just showed it right there. Pretty good arm, too.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. On play action, it's Wentz. And he's got it. It's caught for a Packers touchdown. 3 touchdown passes now for Carson Wentz. And the Packers add on to their lead. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind, because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you really
Packer pressure, and down he goes.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Well, they're in some hot water now. After that sack, it's second and 21. To throw, McNabb. That one's complete to Tomlinson. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. McNabb. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Now we're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. They'll try and throw for it here. Pressure from his right, and he goes down hard, flat on his back. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone. Try to get this running game going with Williams. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Call it a loss of two on the play. And that'll make it second and 12. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Again, it's Williams. And he'll at least get him inside the red zone here, down to about the 19. 1 yard officially on the pickup, and it'll leave him with a third and 11.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Now Wentz on third down. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Carson Wentz with touchdown pass number 4 on the afternoon. And the Packers add 6 to their lead. And his kick is good. Now McManus on to kick this one off. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line.
There's never a good place on the field to fumble the ball. Let's just call it as it is.
But definitely not in your own red zone.
In your own red zone, it's heightened, isn't it? Because you're almost automatically giving up a score and the momentum, and everything just changes for your team.
Yeah, so the kickoff fumble, now great field position. Looking for the end zone. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss him? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
Rolling to his left. And able to get this down inside the 15 to either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. The improv act there, good for nine, and now they'll be looking at a third and short, third and one. They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. Back now in Baltimore. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number four. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll take this one in for a Packer touchdown. Ricky Williams punching it in from a yard away. And the Packers are pouring it on. Now McManus on to kick this one off. That'll be taken in the end zone. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do and the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
He's got a man complete, and he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A gain of 39 that time. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs. But bottom line is he takes care of the ball well for them, so they'll keep handing it to him.
Second down, McNabb. He's going to float this over the middle, deep. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
McNabb to throw. And Winslow brings it in over the middle. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Well, in the grand scheme of things, those 3 points likely not going to matter much, but I guess they get a little closer, a little more respectability.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been outplayed all game long, but like my mom used to tell me all the time before I went out, dress up a little bit, son. Make yourself respectable. And that's what they're doing here. They're just dressing up the final score.
And he spins away. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line.
And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. The outcome of this one, well, we know who's going to win it. It's just all window dressing at this point. Got me thinking, what's the biggest blowout that you've been a part of as a player, broadcaster?
But I'm not going to go to the player part because when I think blowout.
Because you won every game.
No. I think about being blown out. And no one wants to go back to those memories. But, you know, when I was calling college football, I saw a game that, you know, a team put 70. I actually saw it happen twice. A team put 70 on their opponent. And in the NFL in the 2017 season, I saw one of those changing of the guard games where a team that hadn't been very good before now was dominating and kicking around a team who had been ruling their division.
And that's when you earn your paycheck, right? As the analyst, you got to fill that time.
You've got to know what's going on out there and how it all happened.
Well, obviously, that begs the question. What game was it?
That was Seattle hosting Los Angeles, the Rams.
Ah, yeah.
Their second meeting of the season, and the Rams turned it around from their first one and blew out the Seahawks.
The Packers on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This is going to be 3rd and 13. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll bring up a 4th down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on 4th and 8. They'll go for it. It's Wentz. Dropped it, and the ball will go over on downs on the short side of the field. So we were looking at each other up here in the booth when they went for that, saying, oh, wow, talk about trying to add insult to injury.
Some teams are just like that. You know, some philosophies, some coaches are like, look, when I got a chance to put some more points on the board, I don't care what the situation, I'm going to do it. And they're also the same coaches, as a general rule, that if someone does it to them, you won't hear a peep of protest out of them. That's just who they are.
On first down, it's McNabb. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked up by Minkah Fitzpatrick. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent. And now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
To throw. And Cooks has it over the middle. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. It'll buy some time right. Now he's going to throw it deep to the other side of the field. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
Wentz again here on 2nd and 10. Staying on his feet. And a big loss here as he's taken down. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this 3rd and long play as we'll get a timeout. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. The Packers on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 3rd and a mile. Ram. On play action, Wentz. He's letting it fly for Cooks. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a 4th down.
Finally, a good play there defensively on the deep ball. The secondary has had its struggles this entire game. Offensively, they've had their way with them.
Tokyo! Lion.
Wentz going to go on fourth down. Dancing to his left. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Chris Jones. He's the one that finally ends up corralling him, and my goodness, that is a disastrous loss.
Now, this is a nice little gift wrap situation as they take over first and goal.
Flex route! Hut!
Tomlinson. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Los Angeles. LaDainian Tomlinson taking it in from 2 yards out. And his guys are able to close that gap just a bit. The offense going to stay on the field as they will line up and go for two. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a two-point conversion, all that extra, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
Now trotting out there, the Packers getting ready to go. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now. They'll put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes. Get out of there.
That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down.
And they just hit another big completion there. And I think in days gone by in the NFL, you might have asked, is this a little bit of overkill? Is this rubbing it in? I don't think people feel the same way nowadays.
It's the age-old argument. Then you could say on the other side, if you're going to get angry about it, stop it, right?
Go ahead and stop me. And I think a lot of the times they just look at it like, let's just play the game. And however it turns out, it turns out.
On the move to his left. And it's intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick.
I think that interception happened for two reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit. And receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. So there's a guy lurking, took the ball for him.
Yeah, so don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open.
Got to know that you're open. Otherwise, just don't do it.
And what are the whistles for? Timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. McNabb. Sliding out of the pocket. He's going to let it fly. This is caught inside the 15. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Kellen Winslow, 42 yards. And that interception key as it leads to the touchdown. Now the offense will stay out there. They're going to line up and try for two.
Come on, let's go. White 90. White 90. Hut. Ohio. Ohio. Hut.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. That's caught for the additional 2 points. It'll only matter to the final scoreline, and that is the final act of this game. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively, stuff that they could look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do. But they also need a little adjustment with their confidence. To give up that many points, even if you win a game, that can hurt you.
So that'll do it from here for Charles Davis and the rest of our crew. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com/Madden. From Baltimore, so long, everybody.
up and I'm feeling like a boss right now. I woke up and I'm feeling like a boss right now. I'm gonna hold it down, I swear. I roll up and I'm smelling like a boss right now. I do this for my rounds, oh yeah. Show you no love, baby. Yeah, I'm a double. I am a boss in the cut. Mayday, bubbles and I'm these models. It's popping, I tip her. I skip her, I give her the. Girl, you on my line right now. Yeah, I can see the signs right now. Feeling like a boss right now. Feeling like a boss right now. And you just took a loss right now. Dripping in the sauce right now. Get a sprinkle of my style. I'm about to lock down.
Feel like in the real life, dripping on sauce in a good life. You shine, I shine, and ain't nobody gonna take my love. I just wanna be a boss. I will never ever fall.
I feel like a boss right now. Talk to another man right now. I swear my life is amazing. No money, no hesitation. Up and down, no basis. I know they be hating, but that's what made me
feel like in the real life, dripping on sauce in a good life.
I ain't folding under pressure, I ain't switching for no. I ain't talking to no cop and I ain't telling on my bros. Ain't no but don't push me, fingers itching on that. Plotting on my come up, gotta watch. Studio, now me and steak and shrimp. I ain't eating sloppy joe. Looking to the mirror, flexing now and in his glow. Bust off like a. Welcome to the rodeo. Shorty wanna me, cousin wearing gold. I came up and made it happen, I was. By the stove, big inside this case is one. Do me dirty, I'ma find you, lay out on the flow. 19 with a, I got rich by myself. Rather do this alone, I wasn't asking for no help. They keep asking how I'm winning with the card that I was dealt. Boy, I work hard for the seat and I ain't buckling my belt. Call my brother on the phone, he said, broski, you a star. I said, brother, hold it down, soon we'll all be living large. And it's crazy how last year was out my garage. Now I'm in a good position for this life, can't sabotage. I ain't folding under pressure, I ain't switching for no. I ain't talking to no cop and I ain't telling on my bros. Ain't no but don't push me, fingers itching on that. Plotting on my come up, gotta watch they at my nose. Long nights I just to hit the studio. Now I'm eating steak and shrimp, I ain't eating sloppy joe. Looking to the mirror, flexing now and in his glow. Bust off like a. Welcome to the rodeo. I got tattoos on my face, I use that as motivation. I can never get a job, so for my dream I'm dedicated. For a second lost myself, I was too busy getting busy. Now they see me out in public and be knowing what my name is. All these rappers want the clout and the life of being famous. I just wanna be stable, tell my family we made it. I was coming for my spot, a young had patient. Now I'm running up, these bands can hit the island for vacation. I've been know my haters, you could say I'm constipated. 5 racks on his fit just to stunt while I'm in Vegas. For my body, shout out to my Caleb Gang. Young got the cake up, now wanna date us. I ain't folding under pressure, I ain't switching for no. I ain't talking to no cop and I ain't telling on my bros. Ain't no but don't push me, fingers itching on that. Plotting on my come up, gotta watch they at my nose. Long nights, just to hit the studio. Now I'm eating steak and shrimp, I ain't eating sloppy joe. Looking to the in his glow, bust off like a. Welcome to the rodeo.
Nothing on that beat.
Addicted to balling, I have to get my cash. The money is calling, got bands, got bands, got bands. I'm addicted to balling. I'm addicted to balling. I have to get my ends. I pull up in my Benz, flexing, counting my bands. Started getting money, I see how it feels to be rich. By the beach now, that's how I should live. Since I was a toddler, I knew that I would become this. I cannot move slow, that's a big, big no. Gotta chase this money, bankroll after big, bankroll. I must get this money, I must get this money. I must get this money, get this money, get this money.
Welcome in, everybody, to another edition of the NFL on EA Sports. It's the Coach, and we're set to bring you coverage from Madden Ultimate Team. Up next, we've got what should be a great matchup between the New England Patriots and the LA Crusaders. So with that, let's head over to the heart of...
The Crusaders, their offense getting ready to go. First down and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
Not in a position where they absolutely have to rush right now, but they definitely have to pick up the tempo a bit.
Back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep down. That's caught at the 25. But he gets this deep into Patriot territory. A big play there for LA. 42 yards. Charles, just a gigantic play right there.
Absolute breakdown defensively, but take no credit away. A huge gain, and that turns things around.
He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow, wow. So many practices we watched over time where the offense works on scoring late in the game and finding a way to win, as we just saw there.
Just saw it right there. Now can they preserve that advantage that they just got? Extra point from McManus is good, and the lead is up to 5. fielded about a yard deep. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, got to get out of bounds and keep the drive going and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't just lay back and let them do whatever they want. So it is a cat and mouse deal here. How much pressure will the defense bring?
And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 21. And he'll bring it all the way back, just a yard or two shy of midfield. Edelman was the intended target. Agreed, that's twice now in this fourth quarter.
As a quarterback, a lot of times you think it's all on you to make plays when you're losing. And here, the play's not there, but he throws it anyway.
Well, as always, partner, an extreme pleasure to share a booth with you. I have to say, I am impressed at your discipline because you came here and you said you were not...
Hello, everybody. Coach here, welcoming you to Madden Ultimate Team. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
And the offense readies for a first down and 10. They'll look to throw. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
That's a nice job right there, partner, because they were able to work down the middle of the field, working in the seams, because I think defensively, they were guarding the sidelines, trying to keep them from getting out of bounds. They took what they gave them, and it was successful.
17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. Probably had 60,000 thinking pass right there, including us in the booth.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That was a big call, big guts on that one. And guess what? That run, it'll pay dividends.
Back to throw. Flushed out right. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
All right, partner, I'm a defender, but I've got to express my admiration there. Moving around, making it happen, and instead of worrying about protecting himself, he goes and gets the first down. I've got to give it to him on that one.
Normally, you don't want your guy taking shots. And now the offense getting set, first and 10. On first and 10, McNabb. Wide open receiver complete. And he is finally out of bounds, just shy of the 5, all the way down at the 6. A big play there for L.A. 59 yards. This will be their first trip to the red zone. They've got it first and goal to go. And they take a knee. Now from the seven, here's second and goal. And they will take a knee here. And now, is it fourth down? No, it's third down. And the field goal unit is out onto the field. From the right hash, and this one just a chipping. And McManus able to put it through, and that draws him level. It's 23-23. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to three.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there, because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
Big Ben and the Steelers with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. The drive will start with Connor. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards, I would dare say.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. Fielded about a yard deep. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game, because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition, let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
As we said, they control their own destiny now. Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete.
You got to remember, because now that we're in overtime, mistakes get magnified. So you got to walk that line between dangerous throw right there. You obviously could not have an interception in this spot.
And nearly was an interception. And that's caught inside the 35. And he is in for the score. And it is absolute stunned silence here as they win it on the road in overtime. A partner, a great game that we got to see, and making it extra special. Not only did I get four...
How to make it in America, real day one, ain't a lot of us. Mom worked two jobs, it was hard for us. Me and sis made it out, now she proud of us. They ain't teach me how to rap in those private schools. Wasn't like my rich friends, had a lot to lose. Less money, less options, lot of rules. So when that first deal came, it was opportune. And shorty got potential. I get love in the north, I get love in the south, yeah. Shawty claims she a feminist, and her feminine. Girl, you know that he average. Girl, you know I'm a savage. They gon' let me in this club in these dirty vans. Clean money, I count stacks with these dirty hands. Do a show, cut the rack with my new advance. 50 bands, 80 bands, 100 bands. I'm the American. Dream.